Greetings everyone, electrical engineer Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at a professional wiring finder with an external generator MS6818. It allows you to search for wiring at a depth of 0.5 meters with a two-pole connection, and up to 2 meters with a single-pole connection. The actual detection depth depends on the material in which the wiring is located and the measurement conditions. This is one of the best wiring finders for little money. About 10 years ago, I was looking for a professional wiring finder for work on sites. The cheapest wiring finders of the same class as this device cost from $350. I thought that these finders were too expensive and used cheaper devices that were an order of magnitude lower in performance. Nowadays, such a professional wiring finder can be purchased for just over $100. The link to this device is in the description. Also, during the video, I will talk about methods for searching for wiring and how to use this finder to detect a cable as accurately as possible. If you like videos about electrics and measuring instruments, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. If you search for a hidden wiring detector on the internet, you will find a lot of different devices. Most partings will be quite cheap, but most often these are AC background detectors, and in reality finding wiring for them is problematic. An example is this device from FNIRSI, which was recently reviewed on the channel. I left a link to the video in the description. The location of the wiring with such devices can be detected in 50% of cases. Even if we take a professional Bosch device of this type, the results will not be better. Often these devices find wiring where there is no trace of it. The results are slightly better with an inexpensive wiring finder that has its own generator, but its detection depth is quite small. And when using it, you need to de-energize the wiring. This wiring finder does not have such problems. What are the capabilities of the device? 1. Detection of cables, electrical lines, water, gas supply pipelines laid in the wall, floor and ground. 2. Detection of breaks and short circuits in cables and electrical lines laid in the wall and ground. 3. Search for sockets and distribution boxes accidentally covered with plaster. 4. Detection of breaks and short circuits in electric heated floors. 5. Detection of low current circuits and faults in them. The device comes in this packaging. The package was wrapped in bubble wrap. Although the packaging was wrinkled, the device arrived completely intact. In fact, this is a set of devices packed in a handbag that is convenient to carry on your shoulder. We open the purse. It contains both devices, a receiver and a generator, wires included. Let's look at them. Here is the wire itself, which at one end is connected to the generator. The second end of the wire is connected to either the probes or alligator clips, depending on how you will connect to the circuit. If you remove this protection, it is convenient to connect the probe to an outlet, where it holds well. There is a place for spare batteries. You need to buy batteries yourself, as the device comes without them. The generator contains a crown-type battery, and the receiver contains 6 AAA batteries. The kit includes a grounding rod for locating underground wiring, good chromed iron. There is a protective cap to prevent the pin from piercing the bag. There is also a loop in the bag that holds the ground electrode. And there are instructions in English. Since this device is a professional one, studying these instructions is mandatory. Let's look at the devices themselves. Let's start with the generator. It allows you to generate a signal with a frequency of 125 kHz, modulated with a coded digital signal. We connect the generator using wires to the object of study, to wiring or pipes. A receiver that has high sensitivity detects this signal. At the same time, we determine either the location of objects or the location of the fault in them. Turn on the generator with this key. It shows the ambient temperature. The temperature at which the generator and receiver operate is from minus 10 to plus 50 degrees. This button enables the selection of signal encoding. You can choose one of 8 codes. The default code is F. It is shown here on the display. Using the up and down buttons, we can select a different signal encoding. Press the code key again. The encoding is remembered. I'll explain why this encoding is needed a little later. Use this button to select the signal level. By default, the minimum level is set. Using the up and down buttons, we can change the output level. Press this button again and remember the level. Use the start button to start generation. Diverging circles indicate that the generator is working. The generator has a self-monitoring function. This scale shows the signal level that actually enters the line. The encoding being sent is immediately displayed. Let's plug the generator into an outlet. We determine where the neutral wire is and where the phase wire is using an indicator screwdriver. We connect the grounding wire to zero. We connect the positive wire to the phase. I recommend twisting the wires together. This way the generator will emit less unnecessary noise. That can interfere with the search for wiring. We have a triangle displayed, indicating that the line is energized. The mains voltage is indicated here. And here the fact is that the current is alternating. If it is constant, then a minus sign will be displayed here. The mains voltage should not exceed 400 volts. The range of measured voltages is from 12 to 400 volts. If the generator is connected to the network under voltage, it cannot be turned off. Here I turn it off. It restarts and stays on again. First, we remove the probes from the socket and then we can turn off the device. This generator operates with and without voltage circuits. It sends a signal to de-energized circuits, which the receiver then finds. The device has a flashlight that can be turned on with this button. The flashlight turns on. Turn it off. If the sound signal bothers you, you can turn it off with this key. This indicates that the signal is turned off. The generator has a convenient stand. You can install a generator like this. There is also a place where you can thread a ribbon and hang the generator in a convenient place. And this is the receiver itself. Turn on the device with this button. Initially, the device turns on in automatic mode, where it selects the gain itself. If the device detects an alternating current background, it indicates this with a triangular sign. The device sensors are located here. I would like to draw your attention to the ineffectiveness of detecting wiring based on the background of alternating current. This icon lights up where there is no trace of wiring. You can completely switch to AC background search by pressing this key. The sound signal can be turned off by holding this key for a long time. With the same button, you can turn on the display backlight. As you can see, the device shows an alternating current background. I think it's him catching the background of the monitor. I think this search mode will rarely be useful to you. A more effective mode is to search for wiring using a generator. Let's exit this mode. We connect the generator. I shorted the ends of the generator wires. If the line is long, they may not be connected. Current from the generator will flow due to the capacitance between the wires. Let me remind you that the signal is high frequency, 125 kHz. I turn on generation. I turn on the receiver. Now it works in automatic mode. Here it shows the signal level emitted by the generator. Shows the signal encoding here. As we see F. And it shows the signal reception level in three ways. The first is the scale. The larger it is, the higher the signal, the closer the wire is to us. The second is a sound signal. The higher the tone, the closer the wire. But it is best to focus on this figure. The higher it is, the closer the wire. I usually focus on her first, to more accurately diagnose the location of the wire. Sometimes you have to switch the device to manual mode. This can be done with this button. Using the up and down buttons, we can adjust the sensitivity. The more circles on this indicator, the higher the sensitivity. Here we go. We adjusted the sensitivity. It's rising. We relate, the signal decreases. We bring it closer to the wire. And the device senses it again. If the batteries are low, it will be displayed in this place. Moreover, the receiver can show both the discharge of its own batteries and the discharge of the generator batteries. They should be changed. Failure to do this will reduce the sensitivity of the device and may force it to turn off. When installing batteries into the device, ensure correct polarity. Failure to observe the polarity may lead to its failure. When storing the device for a long time, I recommend removing the batteries. If you do not press any keys for 10 minutes, the self-shutdown function will work. The generator does not have such a function. Let's look at examples of how the device operates with a single pole connection. With this connection, the detection depth can reach 2 meters. In this figure, we find a cable break. The circuit is de-energized. We connect the generator with one terminal to ground, and the second to the broken wire. We ground the remaining conductors in the cable. This is done so that interference from the generator signal along entire cores does not travel further along the cable. In the place where the signal is interrupted and there is a wire break, to increase detection accuracy, it is also recommended to ground the other end of the broken wire. When finding breaks, it should be taken into account that the transition resistance at the break must be greater than 100 ohm. In this figure, we find the location of wires, boxes, sockets covered with plaster. We also find line breaks. The circuit is de-energized. We connect one generator probe to ground, and the second to the conductor that we will be looking for. We ground all other conductors. The grounding terminal of the socket can be used as a grounding conductor. I would recommend connecting to a grounded reinforcement in the walls. If it is a reinforced concrete house, we are looking for wiring based on the indicators and sound signal. This figure shows open circuit detection using two transmitters. The circuit must be de-energized. On both sides of the broken wire, we connect generators, modulated with different digital signals, for example F and C. We ground the remaining wires. At the breakpoint, the receiver will change the encoding readings from F to C. This will be the exact location of the wire break. In this figure, searching for a break in a heated floor using one generator. This is done in the same way as searching for a break in the wiring. In this picture, searching for a break in a heated floor using two generators. This is done in the same way as searching for a break in the wiring. It should be taken into account that if there is a shielding mat above the heated floor, then it must be turned off. This picture shows how to find tight spots in non-metallic water pipes. A flexible metal spiral tube is inserted into the water supply until it stops. One terminal of the generator is connected to it. The second terminal is connected to ground. Using the receiver, we find where the metal tube has reached. There is a narrowed place. This picture shows the detection of metal pipes in the wall and floor. These pipes must not be grounded. We connect one wire of the generator to the pipe, and the second to ground. We are looking for pipes in the same way as wiring. This picture shows the detection of an underground wire. The circuit must be de-energized. Drive the generator grounding conductor away from the wire location for better detection. Select the power of the generator depending on the depth of the wire and the condition of the soil. First, it is better to look for the wire in the automatic receiver mode. Then, by switching to manual mode and adjusting the sensitivity of the receiver, you can record a more precise location of the wire. Now let's look at the two-pole connection of the device and its capabilities. The detection depth can reach 50 centimeters. This figure shows wiring location detection. The circuit can be energized or not. We connect the generator to the outlet of the circuit that we want to trace. If the circuit is energized, Then the generator displays the value of this voltage, as well as the type of current, direct or alternating. The receiver uses indicators and a sound signal to track the location of the wiring. This figure shows the search for an automaton that controls the circuit. Plug the generator into an outlet. Turn off all machines. In the shield, select the machine using the receiver. That will show the maximum signal. This shows short circuit detection. The circuit must be de-energized. Connect the generator to the wires that are shorted. Short circuits with a resistance of less than 20 ohms are correctly detected. To more accurately identify the location of the short circuit, the wire after the location of the short circuit should be grounded. This figure shows the detection of deep wires. The circuit must be de-energized. The generator is connected to the two ends of the wire located in the wall. It should be taken into account that the distance of the loop wire to the wall should be more than 2 meters. It also shows the detection of several circuits at the same time, or the distribution of a three-phase circuit. Generators are connected each to their own circuit, or each to their own phase. Each generator modulates its circuit with its own digital signal. And depending on what digital signal the receiver shows, we can understand which circuit or phase the found wiring belongs to. The detection of wiring without a generator is also shown here. But this method is not straightforward. In terms of its operating principle, it is similar to cheaper devices that search for alternating current by background. Maybe sometimes this mode will help you, but you shouldn't rely on it. Finding wiring with a generator is more efficient. I analyzed the basic techniques for working with the device. These techniques can be combined. When working with these devices, avoid exposing them to direct sunlight and high temperatures. The operating temperature range of the devices is from minus 10 to 50 degrees Celsius and relative humidity up to 80%. Avoid dust, strong magnetic radiation, high humidity and mechanical vibration. When working with live wiring, follow safety precautions. If you have any questions about the work of the hidden wiring finder, write in the comments. Share the video with those who might be interested in this finder. Please support this video with a like and see you in new and old videos.